going to present is how to set up a continuous integration with CircleCI and in Drupal with using our platform Pantheon. Okay. So.
Oh, it's not moving. More about me. I'm Gerald. customer success engineer at Pantheon. DevOps practitioner, Drupalista since 2010. Drupal Pilipinas core member from the Philippines. Yeah, mabuhay. Hey, next. All right. Okay. So topics: Drupal 8 CI continuous integration, BDD with Behat, composer managed workflow, local development with Lando, Pantheon and Terminus. Hopefully we can finish this by 5 o'clock. Okay. Oops. So continuous integration. So what is CI actually? So continuous integration is a development practice that requires developers to integrate code into shared repository several times a day. So that is especially helpful if you're working in a team. Yeah. So not advisable if you're working alone in the project, so maybe it's a waste of time. But if there's several people working in a single project, yeah, that's really, really helpful. Okay. So why CI then? So higher quality code. So yes, because it automatically run your test suite or test cases. Every code changes when pushed to the remote repository. So increase developer efficiency. So usually you don't need to worry about the error. So since you have test cases, what you need to worry is just writing the logic, the developing the application. Okay. So reduce integration risk. So what this is really, really good because, for example, if you're just working manually with version control, like doing git merge manually, so sometimes it's really hard to resolve the conflicts. And sometimes, you know, you often commit the wrong code. So with CircleCI continuous integration, that's can be taken care of. So increase confidence and morale, yeah. So since the developers or the engineers no need to worry about the risk. So you know, by the end of the week they are all happy. You know, no one's committed a false code in the production, stuff like that. So less time deploying, yeah. So when that the test pass, when it passed the CI, so it will automatically integrate the code. No need to do it manually. And there's a lot of advantages actually. What is that? Okay, so the evolution. So before we get here in this dynamic web application, so let's go back to the history first. So before we have like HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and assets. So like we call it, I don't know, website or web page. So yeah, it's very fast, high performance since it's all static, easy to scale, you know. And but hey, features are limited. So you cannot build the features that you want with just HTML. Okay, so PHP came, the database, and then it getting more complex. So we created a dynamic website, but at the end of the day, we wanted them to serve like use Barnes or Boost or whatever caching CDN to serve the static like way before. Okay, so like there's a the CSS, and then we need to minify it, as well as JS, the assets, we need to optimize it. Okay, and then there's like preprocessor for CSS, and then Drust came in for shell utilities. For WordPress, there's a CLI, Composer for how to manage your dependencies, Gulp for building your style sheets locally, or JavaScript. Okay, and then there's Behat, so it's getting more complex. There's Selenium for testing. Okay, and then there's version control, so it's getting more complex. How about this? Jenkins, Hudson. So this build tools. And yeah, CircleCI. So yeah, it's really complex. So yeah, what we're going to do is just standardize your environment. Like build it once and be happy every day, you know? Just a one-time pain of setting up the workflow. And everybody can enjoy it. So in bold, so in my presentation, this involves Terminus. So it's a command line interface in our platform, Pantheon. And then GitHub for hosting the code. CircleCI for our continuous integration and delivery platform. So Composer for dependency manager. And Lando, if anyone not aware, it's like SAMP, if you know. Maybe SAMP is the most well-known local develop stack. So Lando is one of the, you know, like most awesome today that I can think of, because it uses Docker, and then there's almost zero configuration, so it's really easy to use. And Behat for BDD, okay? And for distributed version control, the Git. And our platform, Pantheon. Okay, so have a glance of what the workflow is. If anyone have questions, please just raise your hand. So basically, so changes happen locally, and then of course when for example you're installing contributed modules, so you just use the Composer require, and then commit the changes in the composer.json file. So let the CircleCI handles everything. Okay, if there's no error, if everything passes, it will install the module in your environment, right? As well as run all the tests. Okay, so the good news is you don't need to learn those stuff, okay? So, but yeah, it's really good that you at least know in terms of like there's a trouble, so you know how to troubleshoot it. So demo, let's make it quick. So just, I have a notes here. So requirements. GitHub token, I think everyone familiar with GitHub already. And then CircleCI token, and Pantheon account. So Pantheon machine token. So why you need token? So because you need to this services talk together. So only the token can make that happen. Okay. So assuming that we're in a command line, that's my first command in creating a project. So Terminus, build project, create, Drupal 8 is the framework that I want to use. And then the name of the project, for example, you can name it like DrupalCamp Singapore D8. And then it will ask for token, so you have to enter it, the GitHub token. And then it will ask also for a CircleCI token. And Yeah, it will ask for the password, your Drupal 8 password when you log in as admin. So the username is admin, but admin, yes. And then it will ask for your password. Okay, so while in the platform, so if you're a member of an agency, for example, like let's say Previous Next or Pace 2 or Trellon, so it will ask if you're a member of those agency, then you can select. Okay, so when it's done, it looks something like that. So yeah, now you may be asking, this is all happening in a remote environment. What if I wanted to run the website locally, right? So you can do your own testing. Like for example, we have three of us working in a style.scss. So it's really good to like we merge our code from time to time, okay? So yeah, we can use this approach. So here I'm going to use Lando. If you're not aware, Lando is like an environment stack made up of Docker. If anyone is aware of Docker already, Docker container. Yeah. Okay. So there. Yeah, build the site. Yeah, in the first setup after you before you run Lando. So because when building with the composer base, all the contrib, the core are excluded locally. It's just your custom modules and custom teams that are there. Aside from that, everything that is not your code, it's not there present. It's not present locally. So you have to run composer install, so it will download the core, the contribs, and stuff that it needs. And then, so the next command that you're going to run is lando init dash recipe Pantheon. So what does it mean is it will copy the exact configuration in your remote environment, because yeah, we have the saying like, hey, it's working my machine, but it's not working in there. So yeah, so we have to, yeah. But and by the way, Lando is also working with the platform SH and other, I mean, I think right now they're working with Akiga already. So this known Drupal hosting companies already using, they're supporting. Okay, so once you run that Lando in it will create a single YAML file called .lando.yaml that contains your application name. So for example, your project earlier is like DrupalCampSG. So the name of the application is Drupal 8 Singapore. And then you run Lando start. So what Lando start does is it will, if the container or Docker container is not present locally, it will pull it from the remote repository from the Docker hub and build the stack. And then, so it will power up the environment. So the first time it will take time, like maybe 5 minutes, depends on your internet speed. Then once it's already started, you have your site is not running yet because there's no database and the settings.php. So you have to pull that in your Pantheon environment. So Lando pull, the code is none because you have already a local copy. So set that to false. And then that's database, because Pantheon has like three environments, dev, test, and live. So right now, let's assume that you have a live and dev environment only. So it will copy the database from your dev environment remotely, as well as the files. So let's not confuse with files and code base. Files is for like assets, sites default files. Okay. And then once it's done, you have a local copy of your environment. So yeah. Okay. So what I've said earlier, so the name, recipe, okay. So config, so this is what inside your lando.yaml file. So framework, Drupal 8. It could be Drupal 7 if you want to install Drupal 7. So the site, for example, it's in my case, Janus. And the ID is, this is the site UUID in our platform. And then, for example, since it's local, you can set this to true, xdebug. But by default, it is false. So if you wanted to have xdebug locally yet, then you can use this. Oops. So, and then Drust. So take note that if you're going to use Pantheon as your platform, Drust 9 is not yet supported officially right now. So currently we're supporting 8, but yeah, you're welcome to install Drust 9, but there's some problem that you may encounter. Okay. And tooling, this is the cool part. So you can install Node, like for example, since you need Node in like those gulp stuff, your local build. PhantomJS, if you're building some like testing or stuff like that. And then like those actually are our external libraries in the platform. So if you're working with the like PDF or print module, so the WHTML to PDF is our external library. And yeah, but we also support image magic if you need it. Okay. And then services. So Lando is very dynamic when, for example, you wanted to add services. Let's say your client requires you to have a Solar server, integrate Solar or integrate Redis. So you can just add there the services that you want. Okay, so just add the index server and the Redis server. Okay, so here, what I need is the node for my gulp CLI. And events, so this is actually cool. So what happens after pulling the, I run Lando pull, so it will run this commands. So I just have to make sure that my local copy is not overridden. So if you guys familiar with features in Drupal 7, yeah. So composer install, just to make sure that all the dependencies, composer packages are installed. So import the configuration, update, run the update DB. So since it's my local machine, I want the devel module and kit to be enabled for the debugging and development purposes. And then the last one is, of course, the cast revealed. Okay? So here, post start. So after the app has been started, or like I run Lando start. So after Lando start, it will run this as well. So npm install gulp cs. So basically, CLI commands, line by line. Okay, so let's see it in action. Oops. Why I'm missing. This is weird. No idea. It's not showing. Oh, yeah. Oh man. Okay, here. Lando. Okay. So take note, Lando will not run if you execute the Lando command outside the directory that has no Lando.yaml. It should be inside Lando, the child directory. Okay. So Lando. start, because I did init already earlier. So it will rebuild the environment. And this is a bit slow because I'm currently using my local proxy for offline development. Oh, by default, Lando will not run if you don't have internet, because it has to connect to their DNS server for the domain. Okay. So. It's making my life difficult. Right. Okay. So let's stop, for example. Lando stop. That's dead. Okay. So yeah, that's how easy it is. So let me walk you through to the anatomy, because I cannot discuss this in just an hour. So there's a lot of involved stuff here. So this is the root directory. Okay. So for CircleCI, it's a hidden directory. And then this is the config.yaml. That actually, where are you? So contains everything for my tools, build steps, right? Okay, so it's here. And for the scripts that it runs, it's here. So yeah, it's just a shell scripts. Okay, so for the Pantheon specific workflow, it's here, it's listed here. So basically, what I'm doing here is, for example, run this. And then, am I in Pantheon YAML? Yeah. So basically, you can put all the stuff that you want here. Like, for example, when some event has been run, it will notify the team in the Slack channel, stuff like that. Like, oh, hey, why you are touching that? Okay, why you're running some stuff in that code? Okay, so basically, yeah, you can also send a notification SMS. So I think Paulio created a library for that, for sending SMS. Yeah, he created that library. So yeah, it's really powerful actually. So yeah, the pain here is like you have to study, but it's not really hard. It's just a YAML file, and then all the commands in there is in PHP, as you can see here. So basically, you can do everything you want. Okay. So for another here. So here is the scripts for the platform specific. It's inside the web, so part of the app directory. Okay, and then for Behat, it's here. I think here, test. So yeah, so you put all your features here in this folder, and then it will automatically run. So you don't need to worry like how it's being run. The CircleCI will pick that up. Okay. So here's the script for Composer, for GitHub, for GitLab. So basically, you can do what you want. So if you're like Bitbucket, you want to use Bitbucket, you can put all your stuff there. It depends to you actually. Okay, questions?
If the tests do not run, where can we see the results?
Ah, here. So since it's CircleCI, so
oh, yeah.
So as you can see, it's all success. If it get red, then something is wrong. Okay, so yep. And then you can create a hook that when it gets failed, it will notify in Slack channel or even email, send an email. So yeah, actually, for example, yeah, it increases actually your efficiency when developing application. You don't need to worry about those repetitive tasks like build a remote server from time to time. This actually will create a development server for you. Test the code there, the changes, and then, yeah, if it's okay, it will automatically merge to master in your dev environment. Yeah. So in Pantheon, we have this feature called multi-dev. So aside from dev, test, and live, so when you're working in your specific branch, you can spin up another dev environment, which we call it multi-dev. So yeah, it's actually like, do we have a limitation in that? 10, yeah, maximum 10. Yeah. And then here in CircleCI, it's free actually. So, but take note that it's very slow in the free tier because it uses a single instance. But yeah, if you're working on a big project, it's makes sense that you have to upgrade. Right? So questions? Maybe I'm so fast, or I'm not explaining it very well.
How are you setting up database with Lando?
Database? Actually, so every, for example, in your application, you have database, you have web server, you have like index server for search, and cache server, which is Redis. So you have 4 containers. So Lando, remember the command earlier that I ran, Lando pool. So when you run Lando in it, it will create all those containers environment, but it's empty. Your database is still empty, 0 tables. But when you run Lando pool, it will export the database in your remote environment, pull it, download it locally, and then import in your database server locally.
So you can define the remote environment for downloading the database dumps.
Yes. Remember, there's a parameter dev. Database ... equals dev equals test, or even if you're into multi-dev, so you can call it like the name of your branch, like feature A, feature B, yeah.
And the connection strings are defined in that configuration?
Actually, it's a naming convention. So if your branch name is feature A, then the parameter is feature A. So it's less configuration. It's more of like a naming convention. Yeah, so for example, I have no failed jobs here, but sometimes even if your code is good, it fails. So what you can do is there's a rebuild here. Where's the rebuild?
Yeah, I think it only shows.
Yeah, it only shows if your job is gets failed. But yeah, in a free tier, that usually happens. So a lot of people complaining, why my CircleCI sucks, it fails all the time. Yes, because you're using the free version. You have to pay to make, you get satisfied what you want. But yeah. So there's actually, for example, here's the best feature of this workflow. So for example, you're working in a feature A, and then your colleague working in feature B, and he is having trouble finding out the bug, which he cannot figure out, okay? So there's a switch command, Lando switch, which you can run locally, and then when you run Lando switch, it will pull the code, the database, and the files of the branch that your colleague is working on, and then run it in your local machine, okay? Then, so collaboration makes easy. It's really powerful. And for example, you fix it, you can Lando push in that environment, and then he can pull.
And it's open source.
Yes, it is. It's really good in a team, actually.
Behat can be extended with other like extras like Mink and others.
Yes, yes.
Pantheon picks it up automatically as long as.
Yeah, yeah. Those stuff are supported by default. Yeah, and then what you can actually do is, before I've been developing a solution for because there's a site like there's like a 2,000 Behat features, right? And it's very slow if you're in that situation because you have to run one by one. So you can actually use the cluster runner, I think. Yeah, I use that cluster runner. So what it does is it will split the test by tags because in Behat there's a tag like homepage, contact us or payment or e-commerce. So it depends on how many tags you have. It will can spin up like even thousands of containers if you have really big servers, and then split the test. So for example, in just one container, if it takes 2 days to run all the Behat tests, maybe you can run it like 5 minutes when you have a really good server with cluster runner. You guys have questions? At the back. How about you, sir? Maybe you have. All right. So yeah, I think that's it.
Thank you.
Yeah, we still have like 20 minutes. If you guys want to ask me. Anyone? In your project, maybe? Maybe you're struggling in your workflow that maybe we can help here. That's the purpose of this event, to help.
This is about continuous integration. Is there a continuous deployment provided by Pantheon?
Well, you can create your own solution because of this. It's very dynamic actually. All you need to have is just the token, and then it can talk to like even if you're using GitLab pipeline. Yeah, so every push or commits in the repository, it will trigger the build. CircleCI will take care of that. So what you need is just webhook to webhook. I did that before, but it's kind of complex. But yeah, no, it pays off when you manage it to run. Yeah. Strange, right? This kind of stuff. But yeah, it's if you wanted to really scale when working in this really big project, this is what you need. You know, goodbye to those manual routines every day. No one. Yeah, it can run your front-end test, Selenium, or whatever, Nightwatch JS, or stuff like that. Your back-end or PHP unit or simple test, you know. Yeah. This solution can take care of that. Right? Okay, no questions? Yeah, I think I'm good.